Hey, Hedgehog Maniacs, fellow Melon Heads, SignDX17 here. Back with part 2 of my playthrough of Doki Doki Exit Music, a Doki Doki Literature Club mod. If you saw my last video with the trouble on the Vannamelon Amino, it went from bad to worse. I'll explain more of it at the end, but you can enjoy this video as I try to take my mind off of it. Thursday. Drearily stirring, I can tell from the snoring figure next to me that Natsuki is still asleep. I rub my eyes, struggling to open them. Oh, that's a nice touch. And like I said in part one, I've seen Bijuu Mike do this, but I don't remember much of it, so I think there's one moment, I think there may be a few moments here and there that I'm going to remember, but just gotta wait and see. Reaching out to my bedside cabinet, I swipe my phone and check the time. Midday. There's no point going to school today. You've already missed half of the day. Besides, I don't think Natsuki would be up for it. After last night's... Well, I sit up and decide to head downstairs and make breakfast for the two of us. She appreciate the effort. I try to be as quiet as possible in an attempt to not wake her up while I slip out from under the devil. Nice touch with the music. Anyway, I head to the kitchen and decide to make something quick and easy so I can bring it to her. Searching through my fridge, I find some bacon. Bacon. That was supposed to be a Homer Simpson impression. Sorry. I start mixing together some pancake batter after a short search for the ingredients. As I'm cooking, I hear a light knock on the door. Huh? A knock? Anxious about leaving the cooking food, I rush to answer. Sayori! Hey, Sayori! What are you doing here? I thought you'd be back at school! I step outside, closing the door behind me. I don't want her to know about to know Natsuki is here. I just wonder how long he keep the MC can keep this up. But anyway.
I was planning on it. Look, I just cooked you out of bed this morning. Are you cooking? Smells really sweet.
Sayori peers through my window to see what I'm up to in the kitchen.
Natsuki!
Taking a look myself, I see Natsuki attending to the breakfast. Crap!
I see what's going on, Sonyx!
You do? Something to say. I'm so done for. Yeah, it's supposed to be a surprise for the club. Neither of us were expecting to see you, though. I give Sayori a weak smile in an attempt to reassure her.
Alright, Sanjax. The secret will be safe for me. Well, since you're busy, I'll leave you to Lava's
Bee. Okay, Sayori. To leave, I stop momentarily. I was just wondering, are you going to the club?
I guess, since I'm actually up, I might as well. Especially if you're bringing the cupcakes.
Yeah. This is gonna be an awkward situation. Sayori leaves without another word. I return to the kitchen in a cold sweat. Worry about the false promise I gave to Sayori. Guess I'll have to convince Natsuki that we should cook a batch. She's nearly finished making our meal. The
breakfast. It was supposed to be a surprise. I was gonna wake you up and have it all ready for you. Then Sayori knocked and I...
You could have burned your house down, dummy! Look!
She points the spatula at a plate of charred pancakes.
I guess we're even now, huh? You saved me, and I saved our breakfast.
A part of me wants to scold her for her rap precipitation of what even meant. Another doesn't want to bring up the events of last night with her. I decided I'll make a snide remark, at most. Not quite. Maybe one day.
Maybe.
Natsuki is reading something else outside the club room. Maybe it's because she doesn't have to put a show for the other club members. They always call her cute, though I can surely see why. But she's cute. Anyway, I set the table and sit down with Natsuki. At first she starts eating almost viciously, but quickly snaps out of it, remembering I'm in the room. How is it?
It's delicious!
She continues to scarf her breakfast down, and buying at a slightly slower pace. Sorry if I couldn't pronounce that one word there correctly. Once we're both finished, I take her plate from her and place it in the dishwasher for her.
So, do you want to do anything today?
Well, I kind of promised Sayori that we'd make a batch of cupcakes for the club later. If you want to, then maybe we can set aside a few just for later. Natsuki immediately jumps from her chair, grabbing the apron draped over the oven handle.
Let's do it!
Before I can react, she's tearing through my cupboards and drawers, looking for everything she needs, only occasionally stopping to ask where I can keep certain utensils and ingredients.
Ready to help?
Of course! Hopefully it'll be more useful than last time.
You better be!
Natsuki playfully punches my shoulder.
Don't tell me that seriously, hug! The door! Sidiax, I'm so sorry! I completely forgot!
It's okay. It's only a bruise. You just caught me by surprise, is all. I'm having an extremely hard time trying to play it off. That's right, when you opened that door, when you barred down that door, hurt the shoulder big time. Anyway, that generally hurt. I forgot how much power her small frame can deliver. What do you want me to do first?
Well, I guess we can start preheating the oven to 350. I'll deal with the dry ingredients.
I do my small part and watch Natsuki get started. Another interesting piece of music here. Really liking it. Anyway, she's so precise with her movements. It's almost... hypnotic. Natsuki catches me start staring at her, completely spaced out.
Dummy!
What? I shake my head as I jerk back into the moment.
You were staring!
Oh, sorry. What next?
I've got everything ready to go besides the eggs. Could you crack them into this bowl?
Me trying to show off for you.
Sorry, X. I
finally got you. trying to be sweet. Hey! Natsuki, you're adorable. Natsuki begins to prepare the cake bath. That's a funny exchange right there. Anyway.
Yeah.
but crack a smile as I speak. Maybe a lie I said I didn't enjoy her teasing. It makes her so happy when she gets a reaction out of me. Even if it's only a tiny one. Natsuki and I ice the cupcakes and get ready to leave. Quickly, I head up into my room to get changed into my school uniform. Natsuki without her uniform is forced to wear the clothes I gave her. Seeing as most of the teachers would have left by the time we arrived, she shouldn't end up getting into any trouble. Well, that's right. She doesn't have a school uniform. Concerned about Natsuki's well-being, we never got it. Anyway, I return to the kitchen for a moment to grab some tin foil and cover the cupcakes with it to protect them. Natsuki notices and heads out the door. I follow. As we are walking down the street, Sayori calls out to us from her door.
Hey!
Natsuki grabs my arm, signaling me to stop walking as Sayori catches up. School grounds. This is actually a nice touch. Natsuki, Sayori, and I make our way to the school. Sayori is actually quite normal considering what happened just a few days ago. Still concerned about what's gonna happen next. Come to think of it, Natsuki is too. Perhaps they wouldn't like to dwell on dark times, you'd think. Especially on my dark times right now with the trio. Anyway. I don't blame them. I just can't help but be reminded of their traumatic events. Within a few minutes of we arrive at school, only the last few students trickle out from the doors as it's the end of the school day. The three of us make our way to the club room, being careful not to drop the cupcakes. I set the cupcakes down on the desk near the door.
Hey, Yuri!
Sayori runs up to Yuri and gives her a hug.
Sayori!
Sorry!
Sorry, you startled me. Where have you two been? Feeling well?
Yeah, I haven't seen you slept in a few days. I was really sick.
Me too.
Well, glad you two are back now, healthy.
Yeah.
Natsuki, where's your uniform?
Natsuki doubtfully. It's like Yuri knows something's up or something. Might want to keep an eye on Yuri. Instead of calling her out though, she changes the subject.
By the way, I have a surprise for you all.
Cupcakes. I've already missed the majority of classes this week, so what's one more day? Especially if it means I get to bake.
box of cupcakes and lifts up the foil, showing off her handiwork.
Such a deep shade of blue. They look delectable.
Thanks!
Juice in hand.
I have something for all of you.
Yuri lifts her bag up, puts the bag onto her desk and unpacks a new tea set.
It's not much, but I thought it'd be nice to share.
The new set has 5 cups. One for each of us. Each one has one of our names painted onto it in a different color. That's actually nice, Yuri. The teapot has literature club written in script across the middle of each side.
Thanks, Yuri! This looks so... elegant!
Thank you!
And it gets a little bigger! Thanks, Yuri!
This must have taken quite some preparation. Thanks! Yuri clearly uncomfortable with the moment of attention being given to her, turns towards Monika, who hasn't said a word. I still don't feel right about this. Anyway.
Oh, good job, Yuri.
Could she have sounded any more monotone? She's still upset about the festival. But I think it's something more. Anyway. Yuri politely nods and retreats back to her novel. Sayori is writing something down. Can't make out what it is, but it looks like to be a poem.
Hey, Sayori, come on!
Natsuki dragging me by the arm pushes me down under the windowsill. She grabs the next volume of Party Fate Goes from her set, replacing the volume from last night into its rightful spot. We sit and read this volume in silence, besides the occasional giggle from Natsuki. After around 20 minutes, Monika clears her throat to get our attention from across the club room.
Share poems.
Oh no. Left my poem for Natsuki. This is not gonna go well. I'm assuming Natsuki was unable to write one, and presumably Sayori too. This is not going to turn out well.
Well? Have you tried to?
We all stay silent.
I did, but maybe we should wait till tomorrow. Sayori probably couldn't write because they felt ill. But I'm not sure about...
Fine. Tomorrow is then.
We all gather around the table. Manga spacing out. Something else must be bothering her. You guys know I have a problem with Monika, right? Especially what's gonna happen in a few days. If you don't know what I mean. Anyway. Either way, still no excuse to be so cold towards all of us. Yeah, exactly.
You know, I've been excited to use the new tea set. I'm going to boil the kettle. I'm assuming you'll all be having a cup of tea?
Not silently.
I'll get the cupcakes!
Monika pulls a fresh piece of paper from her notebook and begins writing. I start to remember what happens after this. I gotta go on and find out. Natsuki sets the cupcakes down in the center of the table. Yuri returns with the kettle. Monika seems to be oblivious as to what's going on around her. She's writing furiously, pressing the pen deep into the paper. Steam begins to flow from the kettle and Yuri transfers the water into the pot. Yuri pours tea into each of our prospective cups. Moments of silence go by as if they were hours. Monika's really killed the mood with her attitude. Sayori's already filled a cupcake on the tray and bites down onto it. Into it.
Well, Natsuki, this is the best one yet! You just haven't tried this recipe yet?
Sayori, reaching for her teacup, accidentally tips it over, spilling the contents of her Monika's notepad.
Oh no.
Oh, she's mad.
Get your act together. You're supposed to be the vice president.
Monika suddenly takes us all off guard. Sayori, clearly flustered, knocks the overturned teacup onto the ground, shouting across the clubroom floor.
Christ's sake, Sayori, do you even pay attention to what you're doing? You what? You're sorry again? Just like how you were sorry about not showing up for the festival? And drag us down the exit of the hospital with you? That was pretty selfish of you.
Whoa! Monika, you need to shut up.
If Sonyx was here, we could have just continued on without you. Well, Natsuki, considering she probably would have been weaseled her way out of reading anyway.
Everyone besides Monika is in utter shock. I'm in rage. Hospital? Why is she being so hostile? Sayori rushes out of the room crying, quickly followed by Natsuki, who's attempted to comfort her. Yuri has moved from her usual seat to the other side of the room, her face buried in her novel. I stand and Monika glares at me. Monika! What the hell are you doing?
Don't take care of her. She clearly can't take care of herself.
I want to scream at her after what she said. Exactly. I have an urge to slap her. More like slice her. Instead, I rush out the door to consult Sayori and Natsuki. Man, I can hear them in the hallway upstairs, Sayori sobbing, filling the otherwise silent halls. I run up the stairs to see her crying on a bench. Natsuki is alongside her. Hey! It's okay. Monika's just being a... I don't know what she's doing, okay? She probably had a really bad day or something. She's just taking it out on you. I'm not saying it's the right thing to do. What I'm trying to say is... Don't take it to heart. She knows that we're all looking forward to the festival. Sorry for that. Yeah, that was right, sorry. Maybe she just takes things a little harder than the rest of us.
I don't care, Sonny X. That's not how you speak to people.
Exactly.
I'm going home.
Sayori stands. Oh, crap.
I'll walk with you tomorrow. But until Monika stops her campaign to hurt everyone, I'm staying the hell away from the club!
Sayori wipes the remaining of her tears from her cheeks.
You two have fun dealing with her! Tell her that she wants to talk, she knows where I live! Wait! Sayori, come back!
we'll sort it out together. Doesn't that sound better?
Yeah, come on, Sayori. It'll be easier this way. Sayori's entire attitude shifts. She's no longer crying. Her face is completely blank. She turns to me.
Sadiex, I'll see you later. I'm leaving.
We can walk home with you. I don't really want to go back there anyway.
Yeah, me neither.
Sayori looks at the two of us and shakes her head.
No! I just want to be alone right now.
Okay, well, should you join us for dinner tonight? Well, you should join us for dinner tonight. Natsuki gives me an odd look.
Yeah. Did you just say, join us?
Well, yeah. That's part of the reason why Natsuki was already at my house this morning. She had a really bad night and...
No, I'll have to stay home. Maybe my mom will order something out. Some takeout. Have fun.
Sayori turns and heads down the stairs. I have never seen her like that. Not even when I caught her trying to... Natsuki, can you give me a second?
What are you doing?
I just need to call someone, quickly. Natsuki nods and takes off to wait at the end of the hallway. Worried, I ring her mother, who's already at home. I explain what happened and she tells me that there's no reason to be worried. She explains that the doctor had given her some antidepressants during the last trip to the hospital. She tells me that it could just be a side effect of the drugs. She's so sick, I hope she's right. I let her know that I'm still concerned, and to please keep an eye on her. Sayori's mom brushes me off and wishes me a good day. Still worried sick about Sayori, I catch up to Natsuki. Listen, you want to go back to the club, or...
Like hell going back! Now after with that... dream... Now while that dream is still there...
Sorry, I was trying to make sure that I didn't want to say that word, okay? Anyway. Well, I still need to get my bag and stuff, so I guess I'll meet you back at the entrance. You okay with that?
Fine. I'll wait.
Thanks.
Hurry up, though.
I take off back downstairs to the club room. Busting through the door, Yuri nearly jumps out of her seat and Monika, writing on a new, dirtier page of her notepad, turns to face me. Uh-oh.
What do you want?
None of your business! Leaning down at my desk, I pick up my backpack and sling it over my shoulders. Moving back towards the exit, Monika tries to get my attention.
Sonyx, what's wrong with you?
I turn and stare at her in utter disbelief.
What the hell is wrong with you, Monika? Ever since we accidentally ruined your festival event, you've been nothing but pure venom for the club.
More like a yandere psychopath is... More like yandere psychopath is more pursuable.
You are needlessly rude to both Sayori and Natsuki. Neither of which you are in a mental state capable of handling that right now. I understand it was a big day, and it was important to you. But you have no right to lose your... You have no right lose. You have no right to lose your cool on us. Don't think I didn't hear about what you said to Yuri.
I was only partially telling the truth. I knew that Maga had said something to Yuri, but I didn't know what.
Oh, that's so sad, yes? Well, you know that she's been doing, don't you?
Yeah, I do. Yuri's eyes are locked onto me, peering over her book. She's shocked, but won't call my bluff. Yeah, she's been...
trying to sabotage the club, you know? She doesn't want any new members. Not only that, my car rummaging through your stationery yesterday. I only told her that she was being a selfish... dream!
Maga turns and points at Yuri.
You can't fool me, Yuri! I know exactly what's been going on here.
Maga, that's way over the line! How paranoid are you to think?
Shut up and listen to me! You're the very reason that the festival was canceled! Sayori is sick. Of course, you're just wanting me to let go. So I just tell you the same thing I told her. This is my claw. You do what I say. Do I make myself clear?
Crystal clear. But there's one thing. Yuri, care to explain?
Screw you, Monika.
You crazy dream!
Do you not see that this is...
Hey there! Don't cut too deep now, Yuri!
Whatever Monika meant by that, Yuri was affected. Mortified, she drops her novel to the ground and falls back into the chair, stunned. Shoving me out of the way, Monika marches over to Yuri. She stumbles out of the desk and backs away into the closet. Maga follows her. I watch from behind all the commotion.
Whoa.
She grabs her by the wrist and yanks her sleeve up.
No!
Whoa! That's right! Right. Act 2, we see that. Anyway.
Oh, what a shame. You couldn't just help yourself, could you? What did I say, Yuri?
Yuri stays silent. Her eyes feel cold. Monika moves closer, forcing her to make eye contact.
Maybe I didn't make myself clear, Yuri.
I've never seen Maga act like this.
I can't believe what I'm seeing.
You and me both.
Shut up.
That's right. You dare criticize my ability to leave the club again, Yuri. Everyone's gonna know about this. How do you think they feel about you, knowing what you do behind closed doors?
My blood is boiling.
I'm just ready about to knock her out.
I know it's not a nice thing to hit girls right now, but in this case it would be the exception.
Maga, what the hell has gone into you? You're crazy!
Maga lets go of Yuri's arm, pushing Yuri and the desk away from her. Looking at me, she speaks up. Whoa. like seeing Yuri like this.
You want to see crazy, Sonyx? I'll show you crazy!
From her school blazer, she pulls a sheet of paper nearly folded. She thrusts it into my hand. Holy merciful crap. That's the poem! That's the last poem you see before Sayuri does!
That is crazy!
What the hell is this?
The poem that Sayuri sent me on the morning of the festival. She told me everything after. It was supposed to be her suicide note.
Suicide note?
What the hell is wrong with you?
Sayuri, she never...
Monika! I shake my head in disbelief. Wordlessly, I storm out of the club room. I walk down the vacant halls towards the front doors. I can see Natsuki standing outside through the glass.
Are you okay, Sonyx? You look a little...
I'll be okay. It's just Monika who's not okay. I show Sayuri's poem to Natsuki on the walk back to my house. She can't believe what she's looking at either.
You know, Sonyx, that's serious. You think we should check up on her?
After what happened earlier? Yeah, definitely. First we head back to my house just to drop off our school bags. We head towards Sayuri's house. I knock on Sayuri's door. She answers the door but just stares at us. Hey Sayuri, we just want to check on you.
I'm fine. I told you that already. I made pizza and I was just about to eat it. You do enjoy making your dinner.
She edges the door shut. Wait, Sayuri! I wedge my foot into the door before she can close it on us. She tries again, but harder this time. Monika gave me this! I nudge Natsuki, and she nods, giving Sayuri the poem.
Oh yeah! I forgot I said that to her! Whoops! Listen, Sayuri! If you ever want to hang out, or if you want to need anything to talk, anyone to talk to, Sonyx is always happy to listen. We're all friends after all.
Sayuri forces a laugh.
Sure, Natsuki. Where can I find you, Sonyx, please?
Sayuri shuts the door on the two of us. I didn't think she would care that Natsuki was staying with me. Especially considering the day before the festival started, the day before. I think I'm starting to understand why Sayori's acting like that. I don't think the MC does. We'll see what goes. I don't think she would care that Natsuki was staying with me. I should really sit down with Sayuri and explain the situation. Sooner rather than later. Natsuki and I head back to eat and get settled in for the night.
Sonyx!
Yeah?
You barely have any food left! How are we supposed to make dinner?
I don't know. Well, we have to go to the shops, but quickly. It won't be long before they close. I open the closet by the door and grab my jacket. You coming? Because I don't really know what I'm getting.
It's getting pretty cold out there, and I don't have a coat.
Isn't that your place?
No, Sonyx. I don't own one.
I hand Natsuki my coat for the time. time being. Well, hold on to this for now, then. I can handle the weather until we get to the shopping center.
Are you sure? Because I really don't want...
It's fine, believe me. Come on, we're going to have to hurry before the shops close. As we exit the house, a gust of chilly wind hits us both. Natsuki hurriedly pulls my coat on. I shiver violently. We catch the bus and make our way to the store. On the route, the bus passes Natsuki's house. She shovels down in her seat in an attempt to keep it out of her sight. I can understand. You okay? Natsuki wraps her arm around mine.
Yeah.
Shortly, the bus arrives at our stop, and we make our way to the mall. So, where'd you? Natsuki is already dragging me to a nearby clothing store before I can finish my sentence. It's actually a nice touch. I gotta give the creators credit with this. She rips my jacket off and hands it to me.
They are so cute! Oh, Sign X! I don't like this one!
I like it.
You know, it fits you perfectly too. Ow, I look at this scar! It goes perfectly with it!
Natsuki walks to the cash register to pay. Natsuki? Where did you get the money from?
Well, I have to take it from my dad.
You're stealing it?
It's not stealing. Well, I don't like digging it. It's usually for baking stuff. Manga. I was saving it for the Park Rangers box set, but this is more important.
The clerk scans both of her items. The total is a bit steeper than Natsuki expected. Begrudgingly, she brings the scarf back to the rack she found it on. I have an idea. I grab the scarf while she's paying for the jacket and grab a black beanie for myself. You think this would look good on me?
Maybe.
Good enough. I place the two items on the counter and the cashier gives me a sly smile, scanning my things. Natsuki is waiting for me outside. During the time we spend indoors, it had begun to snow outside.
Kind of done with the scarf after all, huh?
Just you wait. Natsuki begins to shiver as we wait. The snow begins to settle as the bus comes to a halt. The snow's beautiful.
Yeah.
We board the bus with our things and sit at the back. I give Natsuki the windowsill. We sit together wordlessly as she becomes more entranced by the snowfall.
The shade will be gone in the morning. It really never sticks.
Yeah, I wish it'd stay a bit longer, too. Natsuki rests her head on my shoulders, still staring out the window.
This is nice.
I wrap my arm around her. We stayed this way for the remainder of the trip back home. As we approach our stop, I grab all of our bags. The bus comes at a stop and we get off. Hey, that really is a nice touch. We're a short walk from the house. Now's probably a good time to...
Hey, Sandy X! How much was the hat after all?
Oh, I actually don't have a clue. I only bought it so I could surprise you with this anyway. I pulled the scarf out from the inside of the hat.
Sorry, Max. You really didn't have to buy me the scarf, you know.
I know I did. I just wanted to. I hold it out and she reaches out to grab it. She really looks cute with that. She looks cute. Trapping around the neck, she beams at me, speechless. Natsuki grabs the sleeves of my jacket. I pull her in close and embrace the moment for as long as possible. Her grip loosens a little.
Sorry.
You shouldn't be.
Okay, I just couldn't stop myself.
It's fine, Natsuki. In fact, this is great. Our responsibilities get the better of us if we separate. I take Natsuki by the hand and we walk to the grocery store. We grab all the ingredients that we need for tonight and head our way. Shoulder really slowly returns, leaving it aching. I do my best to ignore it. As we approach my house, I take a peek over to Sayori's window. Yeah, it's that light right there. See it? See? Her bedroom light is on. I think back to the hospital. I told her I would be there for her no matter what. Break my promise by letting Natsuki stay with me? In a way, I think he did. Anyway, no. No. When I explained the situation with Natsuki, Sayori will understand. I know her. We arrived back at my house. I set the bags onto the ground to unlock the door. Natsuki wanders towards the gate.
Inside. Not just yet. It sounds childish, but I kinda wanna enjoy the snow. Only for a little longer.
Well, wait there and I'll be right back. Swinging open the door to the house, I make a beeline for the refrigerator. I hurriedly throw everything inside, not even bother to take the food out of their bags. I return outside. Natsuki is nowhere to be seen. Splat. The wood seemed to be thin air, however, a snowball hits me square in the face. I recoil, stunned. Hey! That's it. If she wants a snowball fight, I'll give her a snowball fight. I duck for cover behind a bush, and she's already packing another. I begin to collect my own. I hear her footsteps crunch in the snow as she peeps towards me. As I poke my head around, I'm clipped by Natsuki's next snowball. Nice try! I return fire on her. I hit her from the back as she retreats towards the gate. Natsuki lets out a yelp and falls to the ground. Natsuki, now on her hands and knees, holds her back in pain. Oh god, are you okay? I rush over to her side, taking a knee to make sure she's not injured. Natsuki, I'm so sorry! Natsuki scoops a bunch of snow and throws it in my face. Oh, Natsuki! She hops back onto her feet and runs inside giggling. Stunned and covered in snow, I sit and process what just happened for a moment. I brush myself off and head back inside. Natsuki is washing her hands in the kitchen. You win this time. Don't think I'll fall for that again.
Oh yeah?
She leaves the water running for me as I proceed to wash my hands as well. I splash some room temperature water on my face. That's nice.
Oh, come on! I could have done so much worse.
I dry my hands and face using the flannel. I open the fridge and start unloading the bag of ingredients onto the counter.
What did you do it, Sonyx? Sit your butt down! I'm cooking tonight!
You don't want my help at all?
Good on.
Natsuki pauses the movie and turns to me.
About everything! My father!
I can see the tears forming in her eyes.
Sonyx! He has a problem! He's been like this ever since! Ever since my mom left us! I think I was 5! Looking back, I can get why she stopped talking to him. He was a terrible person before, but why me? What did I ever do? I think my dad blames me for leaving. I think that's the reason he drinks so much. He always tells me I remember him of. Oh!
Sorry.
And he hates it!
Natsuki can't even speak. The sobbing is drowning her voice. Natsuki! Just try and breathe, okay? Take your time! We don't have to talk about this right now. We can save this for another day if...
No, Sonyx! I need you to know! Sonyx, ever since I was 14, he's resorted to be borderline torturing me for existing. He only brings home food once a week. It's usually just leftovers from the restaurant. And whenever he drinks, he sees me as my mother. That day you saw me in the hospital, that wasn't even the worst. Believe me, I have tried to run away from him before. A couple years ago, I found my mom's address. It had been something like 11 years since I've seen her. I took the train to her city and when I knocked on the door, she... Sonyx, she slammed the door in my face! Telling me that she left for a reason and she didn't want me! So I came back home because I had nowhere else to go!
Oh my god. This reminds me of a Disney movie, Tangled.
So I came back home because I had nowhere else to go. He found out I went to see my mother. That's when he really started taking his anger out on me. He beat me to the point that I had to cover it up with makeup just to be able to go to school. Of course no one noticed. I secretly hoped that someone would think something was up. I had to explain myself, but I never did. I mean, I was trying to cover up, so I can't really blame them.
She takes a moment, wiping her eyes with her sleeve.
The other night, you know, the drinks. That was the only escape I could think of. I've gone back to the doctor's a few hours after you saw me. Gave me painkillers for my ribs. So I stole a bottle of wine from Dad's rack in the basement. I tried everything to get away from him, but every time... Every god dang time, I would always fail. And I have to go back. Sonyx! I wanted to die. Me wanted it. To get away from him. I thought the pills were bad enough. But I guess the few that I had left were ready to go with. I'm glad. Guess you came to check on me. You were worried. You cared about me. I never It's the first time I can remember. I felt truly happy. All those years. All the pain. Nothing can change the past. But...
I grab Natsuki by the shoulders and hold her tight. Natsuki buries her face into my chest. She's sobbing uncontrollably. I won't let anything else happen to you, Natsuki. I promise. You're here now. I'm always here for you. No matter what. Do you understand? She nods her head, keeping it embedded in my chest. I sit there with her for a while. I don't know what else to do other than let her cry. She's held all this in for so long. She needs to let it out, all out. After a long time, she sits back upright, wiping the tears from her face. While she's drying her eyes, I glance at the clock. It's getting really late. If we plan on attending class tomorrow, we should go to bed. Although there really isn't much point in going. We've already missed a good part of the week anyways.
Thank you, Sonyx, for reading with me at the club, for helping me bake for the festival, for saving my life, for everything, really.
It's no problem, Natsuki. I'll do it again for you.
You're so sweet.
Natsuki, from the day I laid eyes on you, I thought you were perfect. So I tried to impress you. With my trash poems. It's why I spent so much time with you. I really wanted to get to know you. Everything about you was just... wonderful. But... there's one thing I can't stand. You hid this pain from me. I could have helped sooner. I understand that you had your reasons for not telling me, but... Natsuki. I really don't know what else to say other than... I love you. Everything about you makes me feel a way I truly never felt before. Natsuki doesn't know what to do. She sits there for a moment.
I love you too, Sonyx!
She's weeping again. This time, tears of joy, it seems. She wraps her arms around me again, significantly tighter than before. I can't help but think back to the hospital. When Sayori told me that she loved me, is this part of the reason I really couldn't say it back? Yes, it is.
You still want to watch the movie, Sonyx?
Of course. We resume the movie from the beginning. As the movie credits roll, I realize it's now early morning. I nudge Natsuki to stand as she follows. I head to the kitchen for a drink and Natsuki lingers behind me.
Sonyx! Can we sleep together again? I really, really liked it, okay?
Sure. Come on then. Natsuki and I head upstairs to her bedroom. I let her in to change first. She closes the door on me and I wait patiently outside.
Because I say I love you, that doesn't give you the right to peep.
No, I know. She's referencing what happened in the closet of the club. I'll stay out, I promise. Of course I won't invade her privacy. Not without her consent anyway. Like I said, especially considering after what happened when she was trying to get the next volume of Park Fake Rules. Anyway.
Okay, I'm ready. Come in.
inch the door open, and Natsuki is already in bed. I grab my pajamas from my drawer and take off my top as...
Did you really just in front of me?
What's the problem? Natsuki seems tense. As if she just wants to... As if she wants to say something, but it's withholding it in.
Tommy!
Oh, right. I was about to get undressed in front of her. Do I ever stop and think about anything?
Apparently not, man.
Moving out of the hall for a moment, I change into my pajamas. I come back in. I climb onto bed after turning off the light. Natsuki immediately rolls over and holds me tight as she did the night before.
Night, Sonyx!
This is getting interesting so far. I'm just wondering how this is gonna go.
I would usually sign off after saying that, but if you guys remember my last video about trouble on the Vannamelon Amino, things just went from bad to worse. Mini Lemon is on the Vannamelon Amino. It's a complete takeover. And I know you're helping Mini Lemon, Monika. You can't hide from me. I know you're helping Mini Lemon. Because both of you want to get back at Vannamelon for what happened. Monika, I know I said this before, but are you really happy helping Mini Lemon? I'm just saying. But bottom line is, we got to help Vannamelon once again. But until next time, SonyX17 is signing out. And like I said in the last video, stay safe, Vannamelon. I hope you turn out okay. And like I said last year, Vannamelon, I'm coming for you!